Hi again, everyone. Dave Saldana here from Free Press at the National Conference for Media Reform, speaking to you live on Free Speech TV. I'm joined now by Eric Burns, founding co-partner at Bullfight Strategies and former president of Media Matters for America. Eric, glad to have you here.
Yeah, thanks for having me on, Dave. How are you
doing? I'm doing pretty good. The big news in your world is the departure of Glenn Beck from Fox, or the upcoming departure of Glenn Beck. Tell us a little bit about your personal and professional feelings on that issue.
I think Glenn Beck announcing that he is leaving Fox News is really a victory for civil discourse in this country. Glenn Beck, I think, was a real cancerous voice in the media that really, over the last 2 years, he did a lot to really distort the media debate and the political debate in this country, promote a lot of violent rhetoric and even violence. So I think it's really good for all Americans of any political persuasion.
Full disclosure, I worked for Eric at Media Matters in 2008. Can you tell us a little bit about what happens behind the scenes of an organization like Media Matters, how the process of sifting through all of the media and finding the problem spots happens?
Well, it's a pretty complicated operation. I think that, you know, some conservatives have thought that Media Matters were like some bloggers in their mom's basement, but actually there's a staff of 90 folks in a very modern newsroom. They're monitoring all forms of media 20 hours a day, and then identifying lies, moments of misinformation, swift boat attacks coming from the right, doing extensive research to rebut and debunk those attacks. And then there's a very sophisticated communications operation that takes that research and pushes it out all over the media, all over the landscape in Washington and across the country to really try to drive and force some accountability into the media. I think it's been a model that's been very, very successful. I'm very, very proud of the work that I was able to do at Media Matters. And, you know, the fact that Glenn Beck is not going to be on Fox News anymore, I think is just, you know, another example of the great work that the organization does.
Now, your former boss, my former boss, David Brock, wrote a book called The Republican Noise Machine that he admittedly was a part of in his days as a conservative writer. And he explains how the echo chamber works. And I know that a big part of your work at Media Matters was trying to build a response to that from the progressive side. Explain to our viewers what the echo chamber is and how it works.
Well, on the conservative side, I mean, what the echo chamber really talks about on the right is for the last 30 years, conservatives have spent billions of dollars to create infrastructure that amplifies their message and allows them to really dominate media conversations and media cycles. So if you think about Rush Limbaugh and the power that he has, there is a little Rush Limbaugh in almost every town in America. There are hundreds of them. And that doesn't even count to like the political juggernaut that's become Fox News. So we've worked very, very hard at Media Matters. I've worked very, very hard and continue to in my new company, Bullfight Strategies, to develop a better, more effective echo chamber for the left to compete in a media environment where it's sadly, the loudest shouting voice tends to win and tends to drive the narrative. So we've got a lot of work to do in the progressive movement about coordinating all the different resources that are there, but they are there, and we're going to continue to do that. Moving forward.
Now tell me, the conservative side seems to have a very good star generating system.
Yes.
You know, they find their stars of the moment and they pump them up until they become, you know, Glenn Beck was working at a little nickel and dime shop somewhere in the Pacific Northwest, and suddenly he's everywhere.
Yep.
What do you think that the progressive side needs to do to mimic that?
Look, we have to build talent. We have to build a bench, and that's something that I was been very concerned about at Media Matters, as you know, Dave. I started a media pundit training program there called the Progressive Talent Initiative, which has been very, very successful in identifying new voices that can be trained in how to actually effectively communicate a message, rebut conservative attacks, things like that, and actually go out and compellingly deliver a progressive viewpoint on an issue or just generally about our values. On the air. On the right, they've been doing this for many, 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 many years, and there's a group called the Leadership Institute, and they graduate 600 conservatives a year, and the first thing that anyone is taught working in the conservative movement is how to talk and think in sound bites, how to spin an issue and attack a progressive. And yeah, we've heard, I think, just kind of like unprecedented vitriol, negative language. You know, everybody who's not in line with the Tea Party is either a socialist, a communist, they're un-American, they're helping the terrorists. You know, and on the right, they actually coordinate this stuff very well, and it's because they're all trained from a very, very early age to do that. Now, of course, I would never want to be involved in creating something like that for the left that was involved in misinforming people. But there is something to be said for learning from your enemy or your adversary, if you will, not your enemy, and taking the best of what they do well. And they have done a fantastic job of training two generations of conservatives, and we need to do a better job of that in the Democratic Party than in the progressive movement.
Tell me how you're putting that into motion at Bullfight.
Well, I'm actually working with a number of folks to build additional independent media capacity, progressive media infrastructure that, I can't go into too much detail about now, but I think it's going to be very, very exciting.
Super secret stuff.
Yeah, double secret, top secret stuff. There's like a bunker underground where we go meet. Seriously, there's just a need for additional media and media that's focused on driving a message. And also we're focused on developing software technology solutions that are going to make it easier for all the different progressive voices around the country, all the radio stations out there, and all the pundits out there to coordinate a little better, to understand what everybody else is up to, so that Democrats and progressives can actually have a little more of a coordinated message in this increasingly media dominated political environment that we're in.
We just have a few seconds left. So what's your soundbite to grassroots activists out there who need to build their own local star system, who need to build their own local echo chamber?
The soundbite is whatever issue you care about most, the second issue you need to care about is how that issue is being translated into the media. It's everybody's problem. So you've got to get involved, because that's the only way that we're actually going to put some wins on the board.
Thanks very much, Eric Burns, co-founder and partner at Bullfight Strategies, former president of Media Matters for America, formerly my boss. I'm Dave Saldana at the National Conference for Media Reform here on Free Speech TV. Come back and join us in a moment.